These are our adventures in Iceland. It's gonna be a bumpy ride.
Worth of wiggle room when we're full of gas, but that's it. So it's gonna be interesting.
Yep, perfect.
We are officially away from the asphalt and into the inlets.
Yep.
Next 300 kilometers, lots of shaking.
That's not supposed to be easy like that. Just wiggle it back in there a little bit further.
Yeah, it looks a lot better.
Okay.
So, wait. What is a mooie foto van het?
Hello!
So that was our German friend.
Yeah, that's our Bundeswehr truck friend. Only a little bit bigger and a lot newer.
Pure coincidence that we meet him in the middle of literally nowhere.
I think it's the fifth time we met.
Random place. That's so cute. Nee, het is niet heel diep.
Nee, het is helemaal niet diep.
Zoveel water.
En even goed kijken, er zitten een paar grote rotsen tussen. It's a very dangerous river crossing.
Yes, very dangerous. Look at how deep it is. Did we survive that? Ooh, it's difficult.
Very difficult. Much difficulty, such row.
After about 150 kilometers of dirt roads and shaking, we arrived at our first cabin slash campsite. Now the wind was fairly hard, so some of the group decided they wanted to sleep in the cabin rather than in their tent. But we of course decided just to sleep in the Unimog because it's cozy and warm with the stove on.
Today's journey is going to be from here all the way to this one and then to the Askia. But first we're going to leave our campsite in the center of Iceland via a little water crossing that was somewhat interesting yesterday, but it kind of dried up.
Yesterday it was really impressive and now it's...
Insert footage of yesterday here. But because it's early in the morning and the glaciers are still kind of cold, there's not a lot of glacial water.
Yeah, it's been freezing this night, so not a lot of melt water today.
It's not dried up.
That's not as deep as it was yesterday.
So cute. And it's easy. Looks bumpy, but not very deep.
We'll be right back.
Moon Booter. We are 1,000 meters above sea level right now. And this is a nice route. It's awesome. Also a little bit challenging at some times. We need to put the old log. So nice!
Nice!
I mean, that squeezes between rocks here. Very steep sandy hills, check. Very hot engine, check. This is okay.
Maybe this is the one that he talked about that would be challenging in the afternoon.
Yeah, because the temperature on the glacier is now above zero. And at night it's freezing. So the water only starts flowing in the morning and the afternoon.
His dad just said it's almost like Belgian asphalt.
Yeah, shout out to Mudman. Follow him on Instagram.
That's the one with the orange Jeep.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's behind us right now.
That's the guy that is responsible for my off-road passion. Truck passion, actually.
From the rocks.
And now we are rock crawling. Here's another tip for you, if you didn't already know. if your engine is getting hot, you are wearing a sweater. Put off your sweater and turn on the heat. Because by turning on the heater, you'll be cooling the engine. And as you can see, we're doing pretty tough terrain right now. But the engine stays a little bit warm, nice temperature.
I'm about 85 right now.
Yeah, that's
good.
That's a normal temperature for the mod, at least for this one.
Big already.
Come on. wife just told me I looked, I reminded her like of all Thornberries. You know, the guy with the red mustache.
And the blonde that's filming everything.
I mean, you'll be the judge of that. I'm beat.
Yeah.
That's one heck of a tough road.
I think it lasts for an hour, maybe more. Nothing but shaking.
We've just been bouldering.
Yeah.
So my arms feel like they're 10 feet tall.
Happy to reach a normal road.
Is melting really hard, and it's taken us a little bit by surprise. So some of the road is being washed away, but on the fun side we have lots of crossings now.
Sure.
Today's journey was only 110 kilometers, but it took us about 7 hours, so we are very tired but happy.
So, here we are at the campsite in Askia.
Yes.
Nice and warm inside, and outside it's very windy.
Very pretty.
And very cold.
Very pretty.
Very pretty. And tomorrow we will continue our way, but tomorrow we'll be going to Nýidalur, as someone told me just. There's a gas station there, and we sure hope that we'll make it. So yeah, I'm tired, I'm gonna take a shower, and we'll see you tomorrow.
First crossing of the day. Whee. Did you get wet?
Yes.
How?
Well, I went through a trough a little bit of suggesting. And the water just splashed between the pedals. Right into my face. That's a new one.
You happy?
Yes.
Finally found some snow?
Yes.
No. Damn it.
Swim?
I don't have my swimming gear with me. We're dressed for snow, not for hot springs.
No. The water inside the cauldron here is about 30 degrees Celsius. And it is suitable for swimming.
You're allowed to swim in it even.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How disappointed are you that we can't cross the river by car? It is a bridge.
Yeah, I think the bridge was a better option here. Yeah. Okay, now the exciting part starts. I am driving on reserve.
And how much is in the reserve tank?
Normally it's 40 liters. But because of all the bumping and the angles we've been in, half of that tank has been emptied in the other tank while I was driving.
We guess. We have no idea.
So I'm guesstimating that there's about 20 liters left of that fuel. That should take us about 60 kilometers. So yeah, we'll probably have to use a carry can too. Whoosh.
Yeah,
this is a thing we have to do about every 2 minutes.
Yep.
On our way to the first gas station in 3 days, we stopped at Stuðlagil. This is a river very much known for its basalt columns. It's very pretty.
is that good in it?
Nog niet, ga ik nou doen.
In the parking lot of the ravine, we had to use a jerry can because now my main tank was completely empty, the reserve tank was also completely empty. So I put in a 20 liter jerry can of fuel, and according to the map, in 20 kilometers, there should be a gas station. We'll be able to fill everything back up.
And we're officially back on regular asphalt.
Yep.
Woo! That was a journey. That was intense. Happy to be back?
I'm kind of sad it's over. Really like the off-roading.
Gas station 500 meters. We made it.
Yep.
We made it.
I'm only at 45, so it will take a while.
Have you met a favorite?
90.
90. Okay.
So, 90 liters.
Yeah, 90 liters. Plus the jerry can equals 110 liters used.
And we immediately
stopped.
Between
the north and the south of Iceland.
Woo! And we immediately stopped next door from the gas station to go camping. Because we are done.
This is a typical Icelandic campsite. Oh no, this is luxury. It has a swing.
Ooh.